really fun sensory cinnabar moth. We're going to use some recycled paper I got from the scrap paper bin, a sheet of A4 card, any other bits of red scraps that you might have lying around. This wall was in the cupboard, so I'm using that too. Googly eyes, some paprika with a little bit of water, pasta shells, some rice, and some paint. So, this is the cinnabar moth. Some beautiful red shapes here. So I'm just going to copy these, and I've copied them out onto my paper like this, and then I'm going to cut them out, and then that's going to be. So when you've carefully cut out all your pieces, you're going to then assemble them into the pattern of the moth, like this one. Turn it on so you can see, like that. And then you're going to get some PVA glue and stick these down. For my moth, I'm going to use lots of different red things, or things that I can paint red to make it. So I've gone for lots of different textures. So I've got some natural dry pasta, some rice, some wool, and some of this leftover recycled card. So if I start off with the things that are going to take longer to dry, so this will be the pasta. Right, now we're going to move on to another section. So I'm going to do this part here. I'm going to put some rice. I'm going to cut this red card just randomly into little shapes. And for this one, I'm going to use some wool. Okay, so when you have completely collaged your wonderful sensory moth, it's time to do the eyes. So next is we're going to colour the rest of the moth. So I've got some paprika and water here, and I'm going to use that to paint over my rice. And then for the pasta, I'm going to cheat a little bit and use some paint here. So all you need to do now to make it look a bit more moth-like is cut it into a bit of a shape. So moth's got a beautiful sort of fan shape at the top here. Almost all natural moth.